Hey everyone, and welcome to another weekly angel reading. And my cat Tigger has just jumped up on the sofa, so she will be probably joining us at any moment. But welcome to another week. It's September 1st. I can't believe it. It is another month. I have to say it's my favourite month because it's my birthday month. And so I decided to actually do the monthly messages, my messages of grace, which you can find on my website, with my favourite thing in mind, which is music, or one of my favourite things. So each of the messages, you can actually find a few lyrics and a video to a song that I was told to share with each sign of the zodiac. So anyway, I just wanted to share that with you because I have literally just finished them and now I'm going to do this video for you. So I'm really in the energy of the week and the month this time. We are going to be using Drawing Virtues, Healing with the Angels cards, and let's get on with it and see what they have to say for Monday and Tuesday. Okay, just pull some cards here. Okay, alright, so this is interesting. This is all about us staying in our truth and integrity. This card really reminds me of many of the messages we've been getting recently and always really, and that is to stay true to ourselves, to follow our own hearts, to make our own choices. The angels are saying actually particularly on Tuesday we are going to maybe find ourselves in a position where we need to speak our truth and do what is right for us rather than perhaps what everyone else is doing or what somebody thinks is right for us. So it's really a time to breathe, to open up our throat chakra and let whatever needs to come out, come out. Obviously, you know, we have to use our discernment sometimes as to who we're going to share our truth with. It doesn't mean to say that we have to share everything and be, you know, have no boundaries, but it does mean that where there are things to be said and things to be done for ourselves, for our own well-being, and for the sake of our own integrity, it's a real must, and particularly these next couple of days. They're saying, as I said, Tuesday is important to remember that, okay? All right, so let's see for Monday, for Wednesday and Thursday. Oh, perfect. This is one of my favorite cards, romance. Ooh, yay. So first of all, they're saying that if you are single, to really pay attention to any invites that you get midweek, any people who are asking you to perhaps go places, you know, maybe friends, because there's a possibility of romance. And actually, if you're in a relationship, it's really important that you spend time with your beloved to make that a priority midweek. There's so much going on in our individual lives, but it's really important that you come together and you appreciate all the love in your life. They're saying that whether we're single or in a relationship, the cherub angels, the romance angels, are also all about playfulness and coming together and lightheartedness and fun. So they're sprinkling that magic on our midweek, okay? All right, so actually, and you can ask the romance angels to be with you, to be with your partner, to help you in your love life. Something like, thank you, romance angels, for helping me, supporting me with my love life, for bringing more playfulness and romance into my already existing relationship, perhaps. Or you can ask them what you would like within your romantic partner if you're manifesting one. They're just really wonderful angels, and they're golden and they're pink and they're my favourite colours. I love the romance angels and the cherubs. Okay, so let's see. Aha, okay, wow. This is freedom. And this is such an interesting card, I believe, when we've been talking about being in our truth and then romance. Because it just reminded me of, really, it's the same thing, our freedom of speech, if you like, our freedom to choose how we live our lives. The angels are saying that by the weekend, particularly with all this, you know, speaking our truth and being more playful, you're really going to still want to burst out the seams and, you know, break free of any old habits. They're also pointing to the fact that each of these cards that we've been given for the week are of us being naked, of the women or the angels being naked. So that doesn't necessarily mean literally, but it does mean metaphorically they're saying to not to be afraid of our vulnerability this week, to bear all if we need to let those closest to us get to know us even more. And they're saying that if there's something that you're keeping secret right now that's kind of weighing heavy on you, allow yourself to share it with someone at least that you trust. Let yourself be vulnerable. Vulnerable is beautiful. Vulnerable is all about the heart and the softness and the femininity. Whether we are male or female, we all have feminine energy, and we all deserve to be free to be who we are and to express ourselves in whatever ways that is, whether that's our sexuality, our creativity, whether it's, you know, actually going somewhere. You know, for us, most of us listening to this video are free and get to choose. But we are also sending out lots and lots of blessings to places and people in the world who perhaps may not feel as free right now. There's so much going on in the planet. So we are going to thank the angels for being with us all, and especially with those who feel trapped, who feel afraid, and who do not have the freedom that we have. We ask you to guide us all, to help in any ways that we feel guided to, that we feel most important around the world. There are so many things that we can do, angels, but we ask you to help us make a difference in whatever ways that is going to most fit us, whether that be in Syria, in Egypt, in our corner of the world, our neighbor, our friend, whatever it is. We thank you for helping us to reach out to those who may be feeling less than free right now, whether it be physically, mentally, spiritually, emotionally. We ask you to surround them, and we ask you to help us be a light for those in need. All right, so this is a real running theme for the week, it seems. Our freedom, our truth. You know, to me, romance is all part of that. It's all part of our self-expression. It's all part of being vulnerable, as I say, and being our intimate selves. That is really, you know, goes hand in hand with all of those cards. Letting somebody, or lots of people if you want, see who you really are. And there's nothing wrong with that. You can have boundaries. You don't have to share with every single person. You certainly don't have to do anything that makes you feel uncomfortable. But there's maybe part of you that you would love to share and that you haven't yet. So let this be the week. Okay, I'm sending you lots and lots of blessings. The angels are sending you blessings, and I will speak to you next week. Lots of love.